Right, this is an heavyweight contest, and to be wrestled this time over 6 5-minute rounds. 6 5-minute rounds, two falls, two submissions and a knockout will decide the winner. From Bolton in Lancashire, in the red corner, the toy bulldog, Colin Joynson. From the Midlands, from Birmingham, ladies and gentlemen, Big Pat Roach.
So here we go for our second main bout of the afternoon. 6 5-minute rounds, two falls to decide between the giant from Birmingham, Pat Roach. At 18 stone 12, he's lost a stone since we last saw him in the ring. And his opponent, Colin Joynson, who has gained a stone since we last saw him in the ring, to 17 stone 4.
Seconds away, round one.
So it's just a question of whether Colin Joynson, who is so much shorter, can reach this enormous guy from Birmingham. Roach with the moustache and beard and the plain black trunks. I haven't seen Colin Joynson on television screens in a couple of years. He's now a tenant in a public house in Bolton. And I hardly wait to see what his hours, how his hours of pubnesses have affected his wrestling. One of the strongest men in the ring, of course, but he's up against an even stronger one today. Referee Dave Rees. Yes, he hasn't forgotten a few skills either. It's half Nelson throw while he's holding under that wrist lever. Oh, Pat Roach is not going to have it all his own way by any means, is he? When he decides to get a crotch hold and slam on, he gets one, though, doesn't he? The arm up, keeps against the joint. A typical Roach move, that. But of course his man's not back to canvas anymore. Now he is. Now he can try it. And Roach gives that one up. Joynson goes for the double-handed toe hold with the leg bent right across there, folded up. Roach tries to get out of trouble with a reached face bar, but doesn't really do much good. The arm lock, all through the high. Body check. Ooh, if he starts those, Colin Joynson is going to be in trouble. Nearly 19 stone there, Roach. And a mere 17 stone 4 of Colin Joynson. Stranglehold now, Roach. Just 1 minute left.
Colin.
No.
Still no. Colin Joynson.
No.
Cross press. No, in each case, Joynson can get the shoulder blade off quite easily, even with Roach's weight on him and strength. Roach looks exasperated, the fact he couldn't complete that fall then. Can't understand how a man can be strong enough to push him up from there at all. 15 seconds. Double finger interlock. 5 seconds. And they'll have to break whether they like it or not. Gripped so tight they had to break a bit slowly there to make sure that the fingers are damaged. Well, it's nice to see Colin Joynson back, and he's not done badly in his first round. I've seen some pretty tough fights with him. He does an awful lot of wrestling in Germany, where he goes into the big tournaments there, or he used to before he took his pub.
Seconds away, round two.
Colin will never be back as a full-time wrestler. He's too busy, of course. But, it's nice to see him back on occasion as a part-timer. 5 rounds to go, no score. Roach in the plain black trunks on the left versus Colin Joynson. And went straight back into Dave Reese, the ref. And apologies all round. Quite accidental. And Dave Reese knows it. Body check. Joynson went back on his heels nicely and took it. And took him beautifully on a leg dive as he came in for the second body check. Joynson not doing badly at all. He certainly hasn't forgotten anything since we last saw him a couple of years ago. Mind you, he's had quite a few bouts since then. This is, happens to be his first televised one.
What's your pressure on him, Colin? Are you all right, referee?
So still checking with the ref that he's okay. I must admit, Dave Reese is looking a bit white around the gills. He got a heck of a body check.
What's your pressure on him, Colin?
There's no...
Right against the joint, that arm went down. And Roach stands back very sportingly, even gets a hand from his opponent there for standing back and told immediately. Yeah. All wrestlers should do, of course, but I'm afraid they don't always. There's a tremendous strength move here, both with a double interlock, finger interlock, and trying to get the advantage over the top. Roach wisely changed tactics then, and got the advantage from a single finger interlock. Right through that posting. Well, the fourth one decided Roach he couldn't take it more for the moment. So Joynson wisely following it up, and he's caught in a sudden headlock, and the foot does the rest.
Three, four, five, six, seven.
Joynson.
No. No. No, mate. No. No, no, no. No.
Oh, the arm is very truly locked there now. Right against the joint. Joynson could be in trouble from this. Roach brings him back to canvas as he's trying. He's got in there. He's still got that arm lever on. And he's trying once again to keep those shoulder blades down for three. Just a minute, he's got. Nicely up. Tries the whip, but Roach won't go with it. And it's Joynson trying the same sort of move now on Roach's left arm. Less than half a minute. Joynson really forcing it up. 12 seconds to go.
No. Yes.
Just 3 seconds he's going to take it, that's all. Big Pat Roach. Follow him to his corner. Didn't seem to be want too long in his corner, does he? He's hardly got there before he's got about 6 seconds before he's got to go again. Generally, they like a little longer with their seconds.
Seconds away, round three.
Round three, and still no score. Joynson versus Roach. Roach, plain black trunks. A bearded giant from Birmingham. Body check was perfectly timed. Just as Joynson got it. Couldn't have got his balance right. And the Roach starting with the forearms now. Now he's weakened, he goes, oh yes, a knee drop follow-up. And a follow-up with a cross press, and this time can he hold it? This time he's sufficiently weakened, and Roach holds it on a cross press in 50 seconds of round three. First one to Roach.
And 50 seconds of round three. The first fall of the contest goes to the battle in Brummie, Pat Roach.
Well, when you have a chance to see the new James Bond movie called Never Say Never Again, the part of Lippy, Sean Connery, of course, Lippy, will be played by Pat Roach, his main adversary right throughout the picture. Round four, three to go.
Seconds away, round four.
So can Joynson come back into this now? Really taking his forearm. Just some overexcitement at the moment, that's all. He stopped immediately.